everyone, in this tutorial we're going to create the Giannis Antetokounmpo poster design in GIMP. Which jersey is more contrast by using the Bezier tool and Hue and Saturation menu in GIMP. Let's begin. Create a new canvas in Val, New, and I set to this size. This is the Instagram portrait size. Just hit OK. Then let's add the image in Val, Open, and adjust this. So this is my recent selection with the Bezier tool. You can see my previous video how to create a selection with the Bezier tool or the in-depth selection. I put a link in description. Watch that video if you want to remove the background in GIMP. And place it on here. Just drag it. And let's scale it down a little with Shift S. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling to make it proportional scale around this. And press Enter. Now create a contrast for the jersey with the Bezier tool, press B. And only select for the jersey, I start from here, just follow the shape of the jersey. When almost finished, hold Ctrl, then click. And press Enter. It will create a selection, then press Ctrl C to copy, then Ctrl V to paste. We'll create a floating selection like this. Just click this create new layer. As we can see, this for this only part. And for the shoes, let's merge it later. Make sure we're on this layer. And now select for the shoes. Hold Ctrl, then click. And press Enter. Right on this layer, press Ctrl C to copy, then Ctrl V to paste. And click this create new layer. And as we can see, this for the shoes part, this for the upper part. Let's merge it by right click and choose the merge down. So it will become in this one layer. Let me rename it so you easy to understand. And make it in folders so layer in nice place and arrangement. So I click this icon, animate for the picture one. You can drag this layer to here, so it will sub into the folder, and this to here. Okay, make sure the body in the lower. Now create a black and white color for the skin and the ball. Make sure we're in this body layer, then go to color, desaturate, and click desaturate again. Just hit OK. And adjust the contrast in color, curves. Drag this down, and this to up. Then hit OK. Then create some shadow here. You can click this create new layer, and animate shadow, then hit OK. And just place it under the body layer. With paintbrush tool, click this icon or the shortcut is P. Make sure the black color is active. Then you can increase the size and increase the aspect ratio to make the brush more paints like this. On the shadow layer, just click it. Add more Giannis picture, so I'm just going to fall, open, and adjust this. Right, as you can see, it's already in selection. So just bring up to here. Place it on here, then scale it down a little by holding Shift S. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling around here. And press Enter. Select only the jersey with the Bezier tool, press B. And start from here. Okay, you can turn off this folder to see through this. Almost finished, hold Ctrl till you see this chain icon, then click and press Enter. On this layer, press Ctrl C to copy, then Ctrl V to paste. We'll create a floating selection, just click this create new layer. Alright. For this part and this original layer, so press B again, start from here. Control C to copy, then Control V to paste. Click this create new layer. Merge it down by right click, choose merge down. Let's create a new folder. Name it for. Okay. This for the body. Make a desaturate in body layer. Go to color, desaturate, and choose desaturate again. Let's hit OK. Then adjust the contrast in color curves and adjust it. And for the last image, so I'm going to file, open, and choose this. And I just bring up to here. Hide the picture 1 and picture 2 for now. And with Bezier tool again, press B. And only select the jersey. Start from here. Okay, then press Ctrl C to copy, then Ctrl V to paste. Okay, create a new folder. Name it for the. Place it to here. And remove the line by clicking this Move tool, or the shortcut is M. And make a desaturate in color, desaturate, and click desaturate again. Just hit OK. Adjust the contrast in color, curves. And just turn it down, this to up, and click OK. Now create a layer mask for this part on the jersey layer. Right click, add layer mask, choose this white full opacity, then hit add. And click this paint brush tool, or the shortcut is P. Make sure the black color is active. Brush it. Around here, and same for the body part. Right click, add layer mask, choose this white full opacity, then hit add. And brush in this body layer. You can turn on for the picture 1 and picture 2 to see the result. As we can see, the picture number 2 on the jersey, the color is not in the same, so make it close to this color and this. On the jersey layer, go to color, hue and saturation, and you can turn up the hue a little. Alright, on this, it's slightly close to this, and the saturation a little, then click OK. Here's some tips if you want to move all of this layer on this folder. Just hold shift on the keyboard and click, it will move all layer in this folder. So you're not going to get this. Alright. Let me move this by holding shift on the folder layer. Okay. So it will move the layer in the folder. And this for the picture number 3. Next, add the rectangle with the color for the right side. So with rectangle tool, click this icon. Or the shortcut is R. And select the right side. Okay, layer, name it, and let's change this black color to some of this green color, and click OK, and fill it in edit, just fill it foreground color because our foreground color in this green color. Alright, click the move tool to remove the selection, deselect it and go to select and choose none. Alright, you can change layer mode to hard light. Add the back image in file. Open this layer and adjust this. Scale it up by hitting Shift S. Hold Ctrl Shift while scaling, like this. and press enter. And make a desaturate in color, desaturate, and click desaturate again. And just click OK. Right now, we can reduce the opacity. Run here. Now, the last thing for the text element, press T and type the name. Change the font to, change the size to, move it outside the folder so you can collapse this. And more, so I'm just going to duplicate this. Press T to edit. Change the size to 2. Next, create a rectangle with black color behind the text for highlighting the name. So I'm just going to create a new layer and emit. Place it inside the folder. Rectangle tool, click this icon, or shortcut is R, and select this. Change this green color to its black color. On this layer, go to edit, just fill with foreground color because all foreground color in black color. Change the text color to white and do same for this text. Add a number, so I'm just going to type the number, change the font to right, change the size to, and let's change it to this previous green color, and move the layer below this image, okay, on here. Still can adjust the position by holding shift then click. Add more text for the nickname, so I'm just going to type again. Change the font to, you can reduce the spacing by clicking this to minus. Right. Scale it down. Break. And move the layer to below this picture. And last for the team name for the Milwaukee Bucks, so I'm just going to type again. Press T and type change the font to, change the size to, change it to white color, and let's rotate it by hitting shift R, then hold control shift while scaling to make 15 degree increment like this. Click the move tool, hold shift, then place it on here and move it to the bottom and make it only stroke by right click, apply to selection, and go to select and choose strength, make it by 3. Right, while in selection like this, you see it will create a selection inward the text, so just press delete on the keyboard, hide this edge by scaling it up, press shift S, hold control shift while scaling just a little, run here and press enter. Now add the Milwaukee text here and rotate it by hitting shift R, place it to here. I hope you learned something new about creating a contrast to the jersey with the Bezier tool and using a hue and saturation menu to match the color. I'm Zeke from Zeke Design, create something good today. Thanks for watching.